Down below, you can see a red button. This secret red button allows you to subscribe. Push the red button, and you will finally be happy.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman. I'm a game developer. And today we are going to create something like Tomb Raider. Well, not the whole thing. We're gonna make a character climb like Tomb Raider. Let me show you the demo. Here's the demo. Walk up to this edge. Press up. And you press up again. Let me try that again. Press up. So let's open the working file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there's a link down below where you can download the free version of this software. There's also a paid version which allows you to create commercial games. You know, games you can sell. Incidentally, there is a code there you can use to get it cheaper. Now, let's go over this asset. See that this is just a background. If you double click on Lara, see all her animations. There's the walking animation, running animation, and that's all she has. She has a jumping animation, but it's just one frame. Here are the rest of the animations. I'm going to double click on this one. Climbing. Here's the other half. Now, if you run this frame, notice that you can walk. If you press up over here, nothing happens. Now, I have these two active objects here, which are just pictures. Blue one, pink one. We also have a counter. Let's go to the event editor. And in here, we only have two events. Now, one for colliding with the background and one for sound when she walks. Make a new one for character. It's overlapping another object, this pink object, and the user presses the up key. Then we destroy our character. Let's try it out. Going to press up, and she gets destroyed. Probably make this visible at start. Now, when this happens, we want to create another object, our climb object, which is the animation. We're gonna create it here at the pink object. Let's try it out. Press up. And you can see that that works not too bad. I'm going to copy line 3, paste it, and let's replace this for our new object, which is climb. Notice that we have a blue object here. Let's replace it for the blue object. And delete this here. And instead of destroying the original character, we're going to destroy climbed, the climbing animation. Let's try it out. And you can see that our character disappears. Let me make this visible. Now the character disappears because we need a small delay. Okay, this is why we have this counter here. So when we press up, we add 1 to the counter. New condition. If the counter is greater than 0, we keep adding 1 to it. Now for our second action on the line 4, the counter needs to be greater than, say, 20. Let's try it out. Press up. Press up again. And that works fine. Now, on the line 4, we are going to create the new animation object, the climb up object, relative to the position of the blue object. Let's try it out. Press up. Up again. But now we can move. New condition. When the animation climb up is finished, the stop animation, then we simply destroy the object and we create a new one, a new original object relative to the position of the last animation. Be a little higher here somewhere. Let's make these 2 pixels on the X. Try it out. Press up, up again, and you can see that this works not too bad. Now when we press up, we are going to play a sound, and on the line 4 as well. Try it again. Press up, up again. And that works fine. And that works not too bad. Alright, so you can see that this is extremely simple. There's nothing to it. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like this video, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode.